Hi, I'm Kate, and on this episode of Bite Scized, we're going to be checking out frozen honey. This TikTok trend isn't just packed with sugar, but science too.
If your first reaction is, wait, what? Frozen honey? TikTok? Don't worry, we got you. That's how we felt too, which is why we first started with a brief look at TikTok, and we're going to show you the highlights.
Ooh, what is that? It is worth the hype. Should you try it? Yes. Well, good thing, because we're going to. So the reason I love this idea is that it actually, there's a ton of science behind this. Like immediately, this is all about solutions and freezing point and the fact that honey doesn't freeze. So the science behind this is actually pretty rich, even though I have some mixed feelings about how tasty this frozen honey actually is.
So when you put honey in the freezer, it doesn't fully freeze. And so it gets this taffy-like structure. And I guess that's where all the hype comes in on TikTok. I don't know. We're still fully figuring that out. We tested out 3 different honeys, and for each one, tasted it as well as looked at the texture and how easily it came out of the bottle after we froze it, which proved to actually be the hardest part, funnily enough. Some of them required so much force to just get out of the bottle.
I mean, that looks pretty good. Or gross. I don't know. You decide.
So the reason we're seeing this taffy-like texture of the honey is because it's not fully freezing. And the science behind that? Freezing point depression. Let's look at 3 examples to understand this. So let's say we have 3 glasses of water, and let's say it's 100 grams of water in each one, just to keep the math easy. 100 grams is roughly 4/10 of a cup, so just below half a cup of water. Now the first glass is pure water. And the second glass, we add 50 grams of white sugar, which is 1/4 cup. And the third glass, we add 100 grams or 1/2 cup of sugar. Let's compare the freezing points. So in the first glass, just the pure water, it has a freezing point of 0 degrees Celsius, the freezing point of water. But then we see -2.6 degrees Celsius and -7.2 degrees Celsius for the other 2 solutions. There's a clear trend. What do you think would happen if we added a 1/4 cup with 150 grams of sugar with the water? What do you think the freezing point would be? The freezing point would be -11.4 degrees Celsius. Now let's bring it back to honey. So honey is about 83% sugar and less than 20% water. This is an average. Check out our links below for the research we did to calculate this. So to compare this, we have to convert to percentages. To do that, we're going to take the mass of the solute that we added and divide it by the total mass of the solution. So for example, 50 grams of sugar divided by 150 grams, which is the total mass of the solution, which would be 33%. For our second glass, we'd have 50%, and for the third, we have 60%. So we're nowhere near where we are with honey, with 83% sugar. And the data from the study we used didn't even get to that high of a percentage, but we found other information online that honey's freezing point is about -20 degrees Celsius. And given that our standard freezer is about -16 degrees Celsius, there's no way we could ever bring it down enough to fully freeze it. So the freezing point of a solution is directly impacted by the amount of solute dissolved in it. And by adding sugar to water, the freezing point decreases. And this is actually one of the reasons we add sugar to things like ice cream. It drops the freezing point, so it's still scoopable at a cold temperature.
So after exploring the different types of honey, as well as all of the weird TikTok trends, we're going to do some experimentation because honestly, I think this could be really improved.
In particular, we were intrigued by this idea of adding something like nerds to the frozen honey, although we thought we could still do better.
So I think the reason you can use these other hard candies is that they're not actually dissolving in the honey. So they're not affecting the solution of the honey itself, okay, because it's actually a heterogeneous mixture, which means that basically it's not actually mixing with the honey, so it's not going to affect how the honey is freezing. It's just part of the mix. I'm not really convinced that adding nerds or sprinkles or some other candy is the best idea because honey is already really sweet. I'm thinking we could add in something that is contrasting to the sweet flavors. So maybe we do something like salty or fatty, but it can't dissolve in the honey. What if we do a payday? So basically, right, a payday is just a ton of peanuts with like some sort of corn syrup, sticky, sugary mix, which I think we could totally do with the frozen honey. I got a payday. I'm expecting it to be really sweet. It's actually pretty good. Yeah, and this is just peanuts, sugar, corn syrup are the first 3 ingredients, which honey is essentially sugar and corn syrup. All right, so I'm just gonna literally pour the whole thing in. Oh, it actually looks quite pretty. A ton of peanuts. Now, pouring it back into this is gonna be the hardest. This maybe is the part I didn't fully think through. Oh, crap. All right, we need to rethink this. Okay. So I'm feeling pretty good about this, despite the fact that there's honey everywhere and this is really sticky.
About 4 hours later, well, it was definitely frozen and definitely really hard to get out of the bottle. And we obviously had to rethink that strategy, and don't worry, we did. But eventually we were able to get out of the bottle and give it a taste.
It's pretty good. I mean, it's honey and peanuts. So I think we succeeded in our goal. We have this frozen honey that's kind of caramel-like in texture with the peanuts. It looks pretty similar to our payday. I'm still just not really fully convinced about the frozen honey trend. It's just too much honey. It's too much honey.
Let's go back to freezing point depression for a second. How do we calculate it, and why does it actually occur? We can use this formula to get the change in temperature of the freezing point. Keep in mind, it's the change in temperature, not the actual freezing point. The other values we need is the molality of the solution, which is basically the concentration, so the amount of solute in moles, which we can convert from grams of solute, it's just an amount, over the amount of solvent in kilograms. We also need the freezing point depression constant for the solvent, which you can find in a textbook or online. So why does this actually happen? Well, it's all about the strength of the attractive forces between the molecules in the substance, also known as intermolecular forces. This attractive force increases as the temperature decreases and the substance transitions from a liquid to a solid, and the molecules get closer together. When we add a solute like sugar, we add more particles into the mix, and essentially those particles disrupt and crowd the area, making it harder for those attractive forces to occur at the same strength. As a result, the solution will need to be at a lower temperature to fully freeze and become a solid, and that's why they call it freezing point depression. We're depressing or lowering the temperature of the freezing point. And we'll see that that's directly impacted by how much solute we add to the solution. A couple last minute things. First, freezing point depression is an example of a colligative property, a property of a solution that is directly impacted by the amount of solute in that solution. Other examples are boiling point elevation and osmotic pressure. Second, freezing point depression applies to any solute, not just sugar. Another common example is salt, which lowers the freezing point actually even more so and explains why we salt roads in the winter. A couple of other cool examples of freezing point depression is using antifreeze for cars, and actually even some animals use this principle to help survive cold temperatures. So basically, this goes way beyond the TikTok trend of frozen honey. So our payday was definitely an improvement, but then we had one last idea we just had to try out.
So should we do any other flavors? I did get pretzels.
So it could be kind of like a take five.
I love take fives.
What's a take five again? Are there different layers in the take five bar?
Yeah.
We'll do the honey with the pretzels and the peanuts because I don't think either of those will dissolve. The final bit will be dipping it in chocolate. That part we're definitely not going to add to the honey because that will totally mess up everything. Thoughts?
This is sounding very involved.
I don't think it's going to be that involved. Also, like, this is how my brain works. Ooh, wait, look.
So we started off the same way we did the payday, but added crushed up pretzels into the mix too. And then this is where we changed it up because obviously the last time didn't work very well. We used parchment paper and rolled it up, and that worked so much better. About 4 hours later, it was frozen. We could cut it into a perfectly shaped bar, add the peanut butter, add the melted chocolate, and boom, we're done.
There's a lot going on in a single bite, which I love. We have the chocolate layer, the peanut butter layer, the pretzel, caramel, honey-ish, peanut layer, and all of them create a much more complex, better bite. So this is my improvement on frozen honey. The take five frozen honey bar. Final thoughts. I do think the frozen honey trend is not really worth the hype. And I think it was a little bit hard to work with. I do think we improved it with our take five bar and our payday bar. But I also think overall, honey is not meant to be frozen. Even though it has a cool texture, let's just keep it at room temperature. Oh my god, my hands are so sticky and gross. We need to clean up.